In circuits that have no inductors, the current rises to its maximum value so quickly that we can consider it instantaneous. Current also stops instantaneously. In other words, the circuit's transient time is negligible. For circuits that have inductors, however, the inductance or back EMF created by the inductor causes a measurable delay in the current before it reaches its maximum value. This delay depends on the value of the inductance and the value of any resistance that is connected in series in the circuit. The delay is usually shown on a graph comparing the amount of current that flows as time goes by. Here we see the current increasing in a circuit containing an inductor, but it takes some time to do it. The time required for an inductive circuit to reach its maximum value is directly proportional to the value of its inductance. If the inductance is small, the transient time will be short. If the inductance increases, the transient time will also increase. The greater the inductance, the longer the transient time. On the other hand, the transient time is inversely proportional to resistance. This is because more resistance means less current, and less current means current doesn't increase to a very high value before reaching the steady state value. The greater the resistance, the shorter the transient time. The smaller the resistance, the longer the transient time. This relationship can be expressed mathematically as time constant equals L divided by R, or time in seconds equals inductance in Henry's divided by resistance in ohms. The time value results in a time constant. It takes five of these time constant periods for the current to reach its maximum value. If we show the transient time of a circuit whose maximum current is 1 ampere, then in the first time constant, the current will rise from 0 to 63.2% of its maximum value, or 0.632 ampere. In the next time constant, it will add 63.2% of the remaining current, or 0.232 ampere, to the 0.632 ampere it has already attained, and the total current will therefore be 0.864 ampere. During the succeeding three time constants, the current continues to approach its maximum value in amounts that are 63.2% of the remaining amount. Theoretically, the current never reaches its maximum value, but for all practical purposes, its maximum value is considered to have been reached after five time constants, which is when it has reached 99% of its maximum value. So, in this circuit that has a maximum value of 1 ampere, we know how much the current will grow in each of the five time constants, but we don't know how long the time constant is. To find that out, we employ the time constant formula. Let's assume that our 1 amp circuit has a 100 millihenry inductor and a 1 kilo ohm resistor. To find out how long the time constant is, we insert these values into our time constant formula to get time constant equals 100 millihenries divided by 1 kilo ohms, which gives us 0.0001 seconds, or 100 microseconds. The current in this circuit, therefore, will grow in stages of 100 microseconds for each time constant until it reaches its practical maximum of 1 ampere after five time constants, 500 microseconds. The time constant works in reverse also. When we open this inductive circuit, the amount of time for current to decrease 63.2% from its original value is 100 microseconds. After five time constants, the current decreases 99% from its maximum value and is effectively zero.